Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mildra, and I'm your gaming monk for the evening. Years ago, I said that genres of games are not discrete categories. Around the time I said that was when people were hardlining about anime and cartoons, and whether a point of origin could really be the line anymore. Keep in mind that this was the era where so-called American manga were just starting to hit the shelves, and there was an adjustment period. Arguably, there still is. I mainly said what I did because I was noticing this mindset of taking genres and trying to segregate them individually, like the genre sections in a library or a video rental store. But when you look at the history of art, that's not reflective of reality. However, I will maintain that just because they aren't discrete categories doesn't mean they can't have specific definitions, something I should have made clear at the time. With that said, let me talk about the genre name that has been a walking contradiction since its inception, JRPG, or Japanese role-playing game. I've made it no mystery that I do not care for the term as a descriptor, and will actively resist using it in spite of its popularity. In fact, when Yoshi-P made his comments about the word, I felt a sense of validation on the matter. Now, I will note that I am fully aware that my stance on this is in the minority, but just because something is popular doesn't make it truthful, and I vowed to be a voice for truth. Besides, the whole "it's the standard term, so just use it" comes far too defeatist, at worst, or at best, too designed by gospel. Yes, I know the old adage about when you're in Rome, you do as the Romans do, but we saw how that worked out in Nero's reign. Besides, geekdom and conformity only mix if you're a writer for Kotaku or The Gamer. Now, I will admit some of this video is going to cover things I dipped into during my stream where Xanatrix and I reacted to Short Fat Otaku's video titled Yoshi-P and the JRPG, link in the description. But I'm making this video to have my general thesis in one convenient place that I can point to anytime this subject is broached. With that said, let me explain my issues with the term JRPG and why I use a different approach. For starters, I find the term to be artificial. Now, I'm going off of my own memory of things, but I don't recall the term developing organically through the gaming communities and forums the way others did. Instead, I didn't start hearing the term in the level that we do, until it was parroted around in the 7th generation of gaming consoles, mostly by game journalists and those who stan those same journalists, many of which had a clear favoritism towards Microsoft's platforms. There was a growing sentiment among those same journalists in the wake of the Xbox 360 that Japanese gaming was behind the times. And this was where I started seeing JRPG being used as a pejorative. Or in some cases, you have the endless cringe fest that was the debate between Japanese RPG and Western RPG in the late 2000s and early to mid-2010s. Because of the fact that the term was used so liberally, it never really had an opportunity to define itself, which is why you see so many definitions that nobody can agree on, or have wishy-washy definitions that don't stand up to a hint of scrutiny, sometimes not even by the people making the argument. If you want a couple examples of what I mean by an organically developed genre or subgenre, consider these three. Souls-like, Boomer Shooter, and Character Action. Each of these were born from a game or set of games that ended up causing a ripple effect of other developers creating their own spin on the idea. Souls-like was obviously born from Dark Souls. Demon's Souls arguably, but Dark Souls was the breakout. Much like Roguelike was born from Rogue, and Boomer Shooter as a term was born from the old school shooter renaissance, largely spearheaded by Dusk. Character Action, of course, became the settled term to refer to the stylized form of action found in Devil May Cry and games inspired by Devil May Cry. With each of these, a game can call itself one of these genres, and there's a few assumptions that can be consistently made about how the game will play, because the point of origin is so specific. By contrast, when someone says that a game is a JRPG, there's little to no frame of reference beyond a subjective feel. It could be any number of playstyles, storytelling genres, storytelling tropes, visual styles, and even where the fun factor comes from. I have seen Kingdom Hearts, Disgaea, Shirin the Wanderer, and Dragon Quest all be referred to as JRPG, and the commonalities between them are minuscule at best. You may be tempted to invoke the literal definition of the acronym, and how it implies a game from Japan. I find this ridiculous because that carries the implication that there's some inherent factor to a point of origin. I don't see the same factor being applied to games literally anywhere else. The Witcher is not called a PRPG, and the majority of games and game genres do not have their country of origin used as a prefix. Even in other mediums like music, this is not the case. I've yet to see the likes of, say, Sonata Arctica be referred to primarily as Finnish power metal. Most of the time, it's just power metal. I've seen many forms of this argument, and not a one has dispelled any reasonable doubt as to why one country should be afforded some special exception. Now, you may object to this and say that the defining trait is a manga-esque art style. Well, the problem there is that manga is a medium, not a genre. Just a casual browse through any bookstore will demonstrate a great deal of variation, much in the same way that there's a great deal of variation with comic books or forms of animation. You can't even make the big eyes remark, as that's not a universal trait. Even in Western comics, there's rarely a set art style. Beyond that, imagine if a future installment of Dragon Age had character designs by Tite Kubo of Bleach fame. By the logic of invoking a manga-esque art style, it would become a JRPG. Now, if that seems ridiculous, well, it's because it is. But the point is to show that art style means very little in terms of game genre. Some genres may have one or more art styles than others, but that's usually a consequence of the visual style, attempting to match the gameplay sandbox and encourage both to work in harmony. Art style alone does not magically define a genre. But the turn-based mechanics, I hear you cry. That's where a JRPG is found. Except, as stated above, the likes of Kingdom Hearts is considered a JRPG, as is Final Fantasy XV. The only reason turn-based became such a staple is in the origins of RPGs in video game form, the earliest incarnations being the Dungeons & Dragons attempts on the Play-Doh computer systems in the 1970s. In other words, turn-based is a product of its predecessor, one that does not automatically denote anything but a combat system. This becomes even more dubious as you turn the clock forward, with games that attempt to hybridize the concepts of turn-based and real-time through their own respective sandboxes, yet are given the label. This is the major failing in the term JRPG as a defining term for a game. What it encompasses is far too broad, and the gameplay loop is ill-defined. This is because, by the time the term was in the zeitgeist, there wasn't a point of origin to build around the definition and establish some commonalities. It's a genre title of habit, chewed up and swallowed without giving any kind of thought. Instead, I opt to use the term console style and PC style. This is because of the fact that the patient zero for the console style approach, Dragon Quest, was made to be something akin to the Wizardry series, but simplified for the Famicom. Even if console style games are available on PC these days, that DNA is still present. Besides, some genres of games will inevitably favor certain controller interfaces over others. After all, most people aren't playing fighting games with a mouse and keyboard. In terms of defining gameplay, I have an answer to that with the three-act loop that originally showed up in Dragon Quest and is present in some form or another within the games that appeared in its wake. You go to town to get supplies, you engage in lighter mechanics in a field, then you enter a dungeon which challenges your understanding of said mechanics before repeating the process. To me, PC-style RPGs may have a hub world, but this loop is not exactly present in the same way. And that is why I will not use the term JRPG in my own work, or in the coverage therein on this channel. At most, I will tolerate it, but I'm under no obligation to engage in such a meaningless term. Stay frosty!